Morning children, how are you all? I hope all of you are fine and safe at your homes. Now today we are going to continue with the first chapter, resources. So what are resources? All those things which satisfy human need that have got some use or usability and also some value or worth. So when all these three things are combined, we get resources. Say for example, mobile phone. It is satisfying your need. You are using it, that is, you are making a phone call or messages, and it has also got some value or worth. So what is it? It is called a resource. Now we will study a detailed classification of resources. Under resources we have three parts: natural, human and human made. Now under those three parts we have still furthermore classification, which includes, say for use we have two parts: actual resources and potential resources. I repeat, under natural resources we have use. On the basis of the use we have actual resources and potential resources. Now what are actual resources? Actual resources are those resources whose quantity is known. That is, in what quantity these resources are present is something which we know and we are using it in present. So what are actual resources? All those resources whose quantity is known and we are using those resources at present, they are called actual resources. Now say for example, petroleum. Now it's also an example that we know that there is petroleum present in West Asia, and from the picture also you can see that there is a plant set up over there and two people are running it. So what is it? It becomes an example of actual resources where we actually know, like say for example, petroleum in West Asia, where quantity is something which we also know, and we also know it that we are going to use it in present. So all those resources whose quantity is known and we are using it in present become our actual resources. Now under the same category we have potential resources. Under the same category, second part, we have potential resources. Now what are potential resources? All those resources whose quantity is unknown. We are not knowing the quantity in which it is present and we will be using those resources in future. So what are potential resources? All those resources where quantity of resources is unknown and they are going to be used in future are known as potential resources. Now say for example, technology. Earlier we didn't know that all of us will be carrying smartphones very easily. Earlier we were having landlines connected, but now very few people must be having landlines at their home. All of us are having smartphones, so this becomes the example of potential resources where quantity is not known and those resources are going to be used in future. So under the category of use we were having two parts: actual resources and potential resources. Actual resources where quantity is known and they are being used at present. Potential resources where quantity is unknown and they will be used in future. So this was on the basis of use. Now we have next part on the basis of the origin, that is from where they come. So under origin we have two parts: biotic resources and abiotic resources. Now what are biotic resources? So all those resources which are coming from human, or they are having lives in them, they are having lives in them, are called biotic resources. I will repeat it again: all those resources which are coming from biosphere. What is biosphere? Combination of plant and animal kingdom. So all those resources which are coming from biosphere and having lives in them, they are living organisms, so they are called as biotic resources. Now say for example, plants, animals. What are all these? All these will be coming under the biotic resources. Why? Because they are all coming from the biosphere, that is, they are having lives in them, and so they are known as biotic resources. Plants, animals, birds, insects, all of it. Now under this second part we have is abiotic resources. Now what are abiotic resources? Opposite of biotic resources. All those resources which are not having life in them, they are not coming from the biosphere. All those resources which are not having life in them, they are not coming from the biosphere are called abiotic resources. Say for example, sunlight, temperature, all of it are what? They all become the part of abiotic resource. Why abiotic resources? Because they are all composed of the non-living things. They are not having lives in them. So all those resources which are not having lives in them will be called as abiotic resources, like sunlight, temperature and all of that. So under origin we had two parts, biotic resources and abiotic resources. Biotic resources which are composed of natural living organisms which are having lives in them, plants, animals, etc. And what are abiotic resources? All those resources which are not composed of biosphere, they are composed of non-living things. For example, sunlight, temperature and all of that. So this was the second part. Now we will move to third part, where we have on the basis of the stock, where there are two parts, renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Now we will study renewable resources. So what are renewable resources? All those resources which are available in unlimited quantity and they do not get exhausted. We can reuse them over a period of time. So all those resources which can be replaced naturally are called renewable resources. Now say for example, sunlight. The light which is given by sun, it is not that only today we are going to get that light from sun. Even tomorrow we will get. And so it is never ending. So sunlight is something which we will get for many years. Not for many years, for the whole life. So what is it? It becomes the part of renewable resources, where we can use the sunlight given by the sun for n number of years. Now taking the example of say suppose wind energy. So what is wind energy? Wind energy is produced by wind. So we will be having wind not just for today, but we will be having it for years. So what is it? It becomes the part of renewable resources, where it can be replaced naturally. That today we are having wind, tomorrow we will also have wind, and day after also we will have wind. So that is how it goes. All those resources which are available in unlimited quantity and which will not get exhausted over the period of time, but we can reuse it again, becomes the renewable resources. Example, solar energy, wind energy. Now we will move to non-renewable resources. From the word itself you can make out what are non-renewable resources. All those resources which are available in limited quantity and they get exhausted over the period of time. So all those resources will be termed as non-renewable resources. Now what can be the example of non-renewable resources? Coal and petroleum. Why? Because coal, petroleum, we are going to have it in, we have it in limited quantity. We are not having it in unlimited quantity. So that becomes the example of non-renewable resources. So that was resources on the basis of the stock, where we had two parts, renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Now we will have next part and the last part of resources, which is resources on the basis of the distribution, under which we have ubiquitous resources and localized resources. Ubiquitous resources and localized resources. Now what are ubiquitous resources? So ubiquitous resources are all those resources, are all those natural resources which are present anywhere we live. Say for example, I am living in Gujarat, but these resources, if I am staying in say Maharashtra, I will also be able to avail these resources. Why? Because these are natural resources which are present all over the world. For example, air, wind, water. So what are all these? So all of these are the resources which are present worldwide, wherever we live. So these are called ubiquitous resources. Now next we have is localized resources. Now localized resources are those resources which are available only in certain places. Localized resources are only those resources which are available only in certain places. So say for example, the steel plants in Jamshedpur. Now why it is present only over there? Because these are the resources which are present in particular area or a specific area. They are not present worldwide. They are not present all over the world, but they are present because of their specific region or their specific area. So all those resources which are found only in certain places will be categorized under localized resources. So that was about localized resources. Now we will quickly have a recap of all those resources which we have studied. We had resources first on the basis of the use, resources on the basis of the use, actual resources and potential resources. Second, we had resources on the basis of the origin, on the basis of the origin, biotic and abiotic. Third, we had resources on the basis of the stock, renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Fourth, we had resources on the basis of the distribution. There we had ubiquitous resources and localized resources. So this was the detailed classification of resources, where we had four parts and two each inside it. So I hope you are clear with these detailed classification of resources. Now that is it for today, and I hope you find this chapter easy and interesting. Thank you and have a nice day.